Hi, Brian. Nice to have you again. Today, it's going to be a discussion about Myanmar, what is happening in Myanmar, and maybe why don't you give us the context, historical context, and up to the what we call the constitutional coup of the beginning of the year. I think the purpose of this discussion is that is to debunk a little bit. There's a portraying of the military as being the bad guys and Aung San Suu Kyi to be the good guys, democracy and freedom and so on. And there's no one actually trying to debunk this whole thing, just to give a more accurate image of what is actually happening in Myanmar. So could you give us maybe the background, you know, maybe historical, and what is happening right now in Myanmar?
People are trying to depict this, especially the Western media, and of course the opposition leaders themselves are trying to depict this as if the military just suddenly seized power, that there was some sort of democracy happening, that the government that was ousted was democratically elected, and they're not really going into the details of what led up to that, why the military would have done that. We saw the Western media talk about things like, oh, they arrested Aung San Suu Kyi because she was using unauthorized radios or something. And as I think people who are following my work realize, that as you dig into who Aung San Suu Kyi was, who she was surrounded with, the nature of the opposition, or I should say her government once they got into power, and now they're the opposition, once you start digging into their backgrounds, virtually every single one of them is tied directly to these foreign governments, the United States government through the National Endowment for Democracy or USAID, supposedly private corporate foundations like George Soros's Open Society. But as I've shown, there are documents that admit UK, British government documents that admit the US government was working with Open Society. So they're not independent of each other, they're working together. And so her entire political party and the supposed civil society networks that support her party, this was all a creation of the US and also the British government. And there's also a role that Germany, Australia, and other Western allied governments have been playing. To call that a democratically elected government, a government that is the product of foreign intervention, is completely dishonest, completely inaccurate. It is the product of foreign interference. Democracy is a process of self-determination. Everything about Aung San Suu Kyi's government is literally being decided in foreign capitals. And we're probably going to get into her foreign advisor. She literally had foreigners surrounding her, around her constantly, just determining her policies for her. So there was no element of self-determination here at all. It was basically a modern day colonial administration that they installed into power. This is what the military removed from power.
Yes, remember there was this task force Asia Society meeting in 2009, and you had like very top people from the State Department in 2009. And we, in the task force, there was a Sean Turnell, which is an Australian citizen, and that became actually later a personal advisor of Aung San Suu Kyi. Could you give us a little bit the background of this task force and what was the purpose? Because you see, I went to the paper and there was a lot about talking, not so much about democracy, it was more about how are we going to liberalize Myanmar. Well, when you talk about liberalizing, is how we can get our hands into Myanmar state-owned assets, how we can, you know, like just get into Myanmar and make it a hostage or maybe a US pawn. So can you give us a little bit more information about this paper, this task force?
So this was put out, I'm looking at it right now, it's actually 2010, put out by Asia Society, but it's called Asia Society, but it's basically all these Western interests talking about what they want to do with Asia.
It's the Ford Foundation, right? It's the Ford Foundation behind it, huh?
Actually, many. There's many foundations behind it. So on the task force, you had the then chairman and CEO of USAID. You had retired U.S. Army General Wesley Clark. You had George Soros himself. You had Kenneth Roth from Human Rights Watch, which plays a very prominent role in using human rights to advance these self-serving agendas of the West. And of course, you said Sean Turnell. He was an economist. He's on this task force. He also testified in front of the U.S. government, in front of Congress, and he's involved with Open Society. He's also an advisor to USAID. So he's basically like an intermediary between the U.S. government and Myanmar, because he became Aung San Suu Kyi's advisor. And this wasn't something that was a rumor or people were just accusing Aung San Suu Kyi of this. This is what he himself admits. This is what, when he was introduced in Western forums, they would introduce him as an advisor to Aung San Suu Kyi, an economic advisor. And you're exactly right. It's about market liberalization, which this word liberalization is supposed to sound good, but it just means taking away all barriers, protecting Myanmar's resources, and ensuring that they're used for the people in Myanmar, and allowing foreign interests to just come in and extract them, and to dominate the domestic markets, and to extract resources and ship them out of the country. That's what that means. That's what liberalism is. It's liberating Myanmar's resources from its people, from its sovereignty. And if you listen to Sean Turnell in any talk that he gives, all he talks about is the IMF and the World Bank and how they need to get them in there as part of his plan to restructure Myanmar's economy. That's what we had. We had Aung San Suu Kyi posing as the head of Myanmar's government, but in fact she had, and Sean Turnell is not the only foreign advisor. I'm going to talk about another one here in just a moment, but he is running Myanmar's economic policies, and he's directly interfaced with the U.S. government. This task force was a task force developing U.S. policy toward Myanmar, and then he's whispering into Aung San Suu Kyi's ear about policy Myanmar should adopt in regards to dealing with foreign interests. So they're working both sides. And it was basically a client regime. Aung San Suu Kyi was just a figurehead. Sean Turnell was the one coming up with the economic policy.
Yes, just you and I, we call this a hijacking of democracy. And I think it would be good if you can explain exactly, I mean, why it is not a democracy, why it is actually it's going against the sovereignty of Myanmar, you know, in terms of so touching the media, the information, civil society, and actually politicians, you know, which are all in the hands of the US. Can you explain why we call this hijacking of democracy?
Again, the term democracy is supposed to mean self-determination. It's a group of people deciding for themselves how they're going to do things, how they're going to move their country forward, in what direction and how. If you have a foreign country interfering in virtually every aspect of your nation's socio-economic and political landscape, is that really self-determination? If the head of Myanmar's government was beholden to these supposed advisors, I think it's more accurate to call them handlers. There was another one, Joseph Fisher. He used to work at the British Embassy in Myanmar, and then he's an advisor to Aung San Suu Kyi. And he's the one organizing her communications with other countries and press conferences and things like this. So again, it's not just Sean Turnell, it's also Joseph Fisher from the British Embassy. Could you imagine a Russian diplomat coming out of the embassy in Washington, D.C., and then hanging out in the Oval Office with the U.S. president? How unacceptable that would be, how instantly people would identify that as problematic. But here, Aung San Suu Kyi is surrounded by this entourage of foreigners, of Americans, British, Australians, and people are acting as if this is normal. This is normal, and this is democracy, and that this was a democratically elected government, and not just a client regime hiding behind democracy. You said about hijacking. If we look at the National Endowment for Democracy funding, that they claim they're funding democracy, but what they're really doing is going into the country and creating a parallel to everything that's already in that country, parallel media, media that serves US interests, not the people of Myanmar's interests, legal groups, education, communication, resource management, literally everything a government is supposed to do. The US, through the National Endowment for Democracy, sets up a parallel organization. What they're doing is they're setting it up so that eventually it overwrites the indigenous institutions of any targeted country, including especially Myanmar. It's the NED's penetration of Myanmar's socio-political landscape is very deep, and they have taken over almost everything there. And again, this is why the military intervened.
Could you get back to NED, National Endowment for Democracy?